children, welcome back to the SST classroom. Now this is our fifth video, am I right?
Yes.
In the fourth video, what we have learned? We have learned about the northern plains. We learned about the river basin, that is the Ganga river basin, right? And then we have learned about the Brahmaputra river basin. And then we discussed about the Indus river basin. So today, in this video, we are going to discuss about the life in the region in the northern plains. Okay, so in this what we are going to see, we are going to see about the people, what occupation they are doing in that place and which festival they are celebrating and the place is famous for which center. Okay, so let's start. Now before starting, I will show you one map. This is a map of India. Now we have discussed already Northern Plains, which state comes under the Northern Plains. So the state, again this is a revision, the state which comes under the Northern Plains are Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal and Assam. This all state comes under the Northern Plains. Right children? Now let's discuss about their life and occupation and festival which they are celebrating in that place. So first we start about the Ganga Basin. Which state comes under the Ganga Basin? So state like Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal lie in Ganga Basin. Got it my children? As I explain you, the Ganga is in the center, right? And Brahmaputra is in the east and Indus is in the west. So, according to that, the state which comes under that place that we are going to discuss. Pretty much right? Now let's start about the Ganga Basin. Which state comes under the Ganga Basin? Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal. Now mostly the people in this basin, they are engaged in occupation. Now mostly this northern plains, the people, they are doing the occupation of agriculture because of their fertile land, fertile lands. So as I talk to you about that the place is very fertile because of the rivers, because of all the three rivers which lie in this basin, right? That rivers make us make that land very fertile, and in fertile land it is very easy to grow crop. What in my children? So in the northern plains, mostly the people are engaged in occupation like agriculture. Mostly they are engaged in the occupation like agriculture. And after it, we are going to discuss about the religious cities. Which religious cities are there in that place? So religious city, you know, the people mostly they from across the country and all over the world, they come to go to these religious cities. So your famous the cities are Rishikesh, Varanasi, Allahabad and Haridwar. This is a religious cities mostly all over the world and across the country the people they come to visit to this place. You can say it is a tourist attraction also. After that we see the festival celebrated in this place. So festival like Diwali, Durga Puja, Chhat Puja, Holi, Eid are the famous festivals which are celebrated in that Ganga Basin. Got it my children? So now let's discuss the second about the Brahmaputra River Basin, that which state comes in that and what people are doing over there, which occupation they are doing. Okay? That is the Brahmaputra River Basin. Now we'll see which state comes under this place. State like Arunachal Pradesh, Tripura, this three states lie in the Brahmaputra River basin. So here goes the land is very fertile and mostly you will see the very dense forest in that place. People here, they are engaging in which occupation? Yes, right, agriculture. So talk about because of the fertile land, most of the people are engaged in occupation like agriculture. After that, we see the festivals celebrated in this place. So, which festival is celebrated here? Bihu, Eid and Christmas are most of the people celebrate this festival in that place. That is a Bihu. Can see the picture of Bihu? Eid and Christmas. All right, my children. Now, next we are going to discuss about the Indus Basin. Which state comes in the Indus Basin? Punjab and Haryana. I explained you about the Punjab. That is a land of five water. Panch means five, up means water. So, Punjab and Haryana lie in the state of Indus River Basin. After this sea, mostly this here the river submerged are in this river, the irrigation facilities are developed. And mostly these cities here are densely populated because of good infrastructure and industrial development. Now after that we are going to see the festival celebrated in this place. Festival like Holi, Diwali, Baisakhi and Gurpurab are celebrated in this place. And mostly with the people they are engaging agriculture and non-agriculture activities. Non-agriculture such as manufacturing and dairy farming. What did my children discuss about the importance of Northern Plains? As this Northern Plains is very important because of all these three rivers, that is Ganga River, Brahmaputra River and Indus River, that all this makes the land very fertile. And because of fertile land, as I talked about just now, because of fertility, very easy to grow crops, right? So, this Northern Plains, is a gift to the the gift of Himalayan rivers, and because of the rivers which flow from the slope, which flow from the mountain, along with us, it brings a lot of soil and sediment with us and deposit to the plain areas, and that place it makes the soil very fertile. What is my children? The Northern Plains are also called the granary of India because here mostly the crop which are grown here are, that is the rice, millets, wheat, pulses, etc. are grown here. Now these regions are well developed and this region has well developed agri based industries such as jute, cotton textile, sugar, vegetable, oil, dairy product and leather. Now Northern Plains are thickly populated and well developed in the terms of transport and communication. As this place is very plain and fertile land, so these places are very thickly populated. And as the good infrastructures and communications are well developed in the Northern Plains. Hope you have understood about the Northern Plains, right? So children, what you have to do? You have to read the textbook and you have to underline the important points in your textbook. And after that, in the next video, we are going to discuss about the objectives which is there in your textbook. And later we discuss about the question answers and then worksheet. Thank you.